Alright, so first and foremost, I'm going to give our praises to Yahweh, Baasham, Yehoshai, Baasham, Raka, Kodash. We said I want to set apostles and elders, agree, mention, rule well, and salutation, say the Akemon, say the pushing wood on all truth and sincerity, day in and day out. We say Shalom. Right, you know, just going into tell you word consistent, and you know how we supposed to be consistent for this truth, you know, even preaching this truth and being on the level we're supposed to be in, supposed to be consistent, right? So, you know, just going into the word consistent, the meaning.
Consistent,
right? It's a acting or done in the same way over time. It's a especially so as to be fair or accurate, you know. So it's a acting or done in the same way over time. So it don't matter the period of time that you might be in this shoot or you might be in this thing, it's supposed to be consistent, you know. It's supposed to always be hot. So if you come into the shoot hot, it's supposed to always be on that hot level, you know, on that hot state, right? It's say acting or done in the same way over time, especially so as to be fair or accurate. So let's go down here now. I'll go to the late 16th century in the sense of consistent or composed of. Let's say from Latin consistent. It says standing firm or still existing, right? So it says standing firm, and that's something we're supposed to be for Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh. We're supposed to be standing firm. And standing firm, you know, standing firm, it doesn't matter what has happened to you, no matter what is going through. If you're standing firm, you will be consistent, because you know what you're standing firm to. No matter what is coming your way, you will be rooted to not move or drop, you know, or drop your consistency, right? So, you know, let's go into a little one or two precepts. You know, this is 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 2. It says, preach your word, be instant in season, or be instant in season, out of season. It says, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine. So that is being that consistency, because it says, preach your word. It says, preach your word, be instant in season and out of season. So if you're preaching your word in season and out of season, that means what? You're consistent, you're standing firm, right? The standard firm, even going back to the first meaning here, say acting or done in the same way over time. So it doesn't matter the time that you may face. If you face snow, if you face hot sun, if you face rain, if you face storm, yes, you remain consistent, because you're preaching this word in season and out of season, right? So you're teaching, you're rebuking, and you're always remaining on that level, no matter the season or no matter the time. So you're remaining consistent, and that's something you're supposed to be, no matter if you're true for 10 years. Or how long you need to shoot for, you're supposed to be consistent, because if you don't remain consistent, you end up in that lukewarm level. And you know the Lord do what I lukewarm, right? The Lord know what I lukewarm, because you can spew you out, as the scripture say. So you have to be consistent. They say as the meaning, that's what you know about the first meaning again. They say acting on done in the same way over time, because what goes on is that after a certain amount of time that you've been something, obviously you like let's say you buy a phone. Or you buy a TV, at the moment when you now buy it, you'll love it, because it's something new. It's something new to you, so you'll love it. But after a period of time, it gets redundant. You know, it just gets old, because you know you get fed up by it then, and obviously you end up not using it, you end up not watching the TV, you know. And I just to show you that not consistency, right? But for this truth, it's supposed to remain consistent. And if you're in this truth, you come in hot, stay hot, you know, keep on letting that flame remain burning and never dropping, you know, never getting cold, you know, or never getting lukewarm, you know, like that is it, you know, over the period of time, you sort of feel like, you know, yeah, you can cool on yourself, you're not so, just remain consistent, you know, and grow. It's a, Alright, so let me just get the next scripture here. Same Timothy. This is 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 13. Right? It says till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. Yeah, so it say till I come. Alright, so still like about that. I just have to take a little pause for a little minute. Alright, so going back to the 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 13, it says, till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. So it's till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. So that is what being consistent, you're not giving up. right? You're not dropping your level. You're always continuing. In this gospel. You're always continuing in this word, right? Always continuing this word. So being on a consistent level is a very important thing, right? It says verse 14. It says, "Neglect not the gift that is in thee, which was given thee by prophecy, with the laying on of the hands of the presbytery." Right? It says verse 15. It says, "Meditate upon these things. Give thyself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear to all." So yeah, so meditate upon these things, and also that is remaining consistent, because you're always the same with this truth, you know. You're always meditating day in and day out, so that is to show you're on that level, you know. You're never making a day pass that you're not studying about these words or studying about these things. So that's going back to First Timothy 4 verse 16, and it says, "Take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine, continue in them." So this going into the first, it says consistency, acting or done in the same way over time. So it's saying here, take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine, continue in them. So that is continuing in the same way. It says, "For in doing this thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee." So you know, so being consistent is a very important thing, you know. And don't ever lose that consistency. Don't ever lose that heat, you know. Continue being on continue standing firm. That's going on here again. Even when you go down here to the late 16th century meaning of it, it says standing firm, right? Or still existing. So that means you're standing firm for this gospel. So you know, don't ever lose that. Because even if the scripture says to be a soldier for Yahweh Shai, right? Right, so you know, to always continue being consistent, right? Don't ever lose that spirit, don't ever lose that heat, you know, to lose that consistency, you know, right? Again, a scripture here. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 16 verse 13. It say watch ye, stand fast in the faith. It say quit you like men, and be strong. So you say watch ye and stand fast, you know. That is even standing firm, you know. It says stand fast in the faith, so that is even like going to being consistent and standing firm, you know. And quit like you like men, and be strong, you know. As the scripture said, be show yourself a man, you know. Be men, because the Lord call on who? Men. He call on boys, he call on women, he call on men, you know. So you say watch ye, stand fast in the faith, quit you like men, and be strong, right? And be strong. So you know, it's always be on that consistent level, you know. Though, as I say, you know, as because I agree over again, say watch ye, stand fast. So that means you're always standing for the Lord, you know. You're never dropping that level, the level you're supposed to be, you know. Go to the same. Right, so that was 1 Corinthians 16, verse 13. And now go to 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 58. It say, "Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord." And that's right, because the labor we do for the Lord is we're going to receive a price for it, and we're going to receive glory for it, right? Things that we can't even imagine, you know. And so So it say here, therefore, my beloved brethren, you see, be ye steadfast, unmovable. So it's this here, it says stand firm. So standing firm is what? It means you're not movable, right? And I would say always abounding in the work of the Lord. So going back up to the first meaning for consistent, it say acting or done in the same way. So it's saying I'm always abounding in the Lord. So you're always the same for the Lord. You're always abounding for the Lord. You're never moving, so you're always being what? Consistent with what it is you're doing for the Lord, right? Let's say, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as ye know that your labor your labor is not in vain in the Lord. That's right. So, you know, being consistent is a very important thing, right? Let's see if I got next scripture. I got next scripture here. Second hold on, let's get the next scripture here. Right. This is 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 15, right? It said, therefore, brethren, stand fast. It said, and hold the traditions which ye have been taught, whether by word or our apostles. So it says, therefore, brethren, stand fast. You know that, as I said before, that was standing firm, you know. It says, and hold the traditions which ye have been taught. So, you know, to always keep this. So you're always, that's going back to the first meaning again, a consistent acting or done in the same way over time, right? So it say, and hold the traditions which you have been taught. So you're always holding this. You're always holding the traditions and keeping the word and keeping the things that were written the same way over time. You know, it never changing. So you're always remaining on a consistent level, right? It say, therefore, brethren, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 15. It says, therefore, brethren, stand fast and hold the traditions which you have been taught. It say, whether by word or our epistle, right? So it's always been on a consistent level, right? No matter what it is, you always remain in the same way, always on a hot level, never drop in your consistency, right? Right? You know, and you know, I got end it to that one day, you know, to end it off, you know. So, hey, you know, just a short little video on being consistent. And, say, so, again, you know, hope it was edifying. So, until next time, we say Shalom. So, you know, close enough. And we give our praises to Yahweh, Ba'asham, Yahushai, Ba'asham, Raka, Kodash. Instead of the monastery apostles and elders of great mercy and rule well, and salutations to the Akemos, to the pushing wood and all truth and sincerity, day in and day out, continuing season out of season, we say Shalom.